Gemini. All right, Gemini. I keep forgetting my old. What's up, Divine Moon Goddess? Bam, bam. It's your Divine Moon Goddess coming at you with a little bit of motherfucking tarot. All right, I know I have been MIA. You guys have been working on a lot, as you just seen in the promo video before this one. Got a lot of things coming towards you guys and for you guys. Information and links are in the description box, okay? So, one of the things we're going to look at is, of course, a quick look at November. What is November bringing you? And I just want to say that if you're looking for the tarot channels of people who do readings for an hour and they over clarify, this is not that channel. This is for quick people who got shit to do and just want to hear a quick recap of what's coming up for them in the month. I don't have time to sit and do hour readings for 12 signs. It just ain't the business, you guys. And we don't need to clarify so many times to keep telling you the same message for an hour, okay? I just don't believe in that anymore. So this is a different tarot readers channel. So I'm going to be spreading those vibes out. Whoever loves it. Whoever doesn't. You know, it is what it is. What can I say? I know I have a lot of people who don't watch no more for those reasons, and it's okay. You know, we're going to send them love and lights. All right, so let's get it. Gemini, so this is what's coming up for the month of November for you, okay? So one of the things is, Gemini, I feel like you're definitely going to be in the limelight. You got a lot of people watching you. You got a lot of eyes on you. I just want to tell you, though, that you don't need to be the center of attention to stand out, though, okay? So just remember, don't allow your pride to get in the way. But I do feel like some of you guys are putting yourself out there. You're getting out. You're having fun. You do have success coming. As before, I feel like, Gemini, you were just kind of sitting back waiting for things to come to you. You were waiting for your blessings to come. Amazon ain't gonna fucking deliver all of this shit that you want, right? So I feel like you're finally getting it in your head, like, damn, I gotta get out here and grind. I gotta get out here and get it. I gotta get out here and do, because it's not just gonna be handed to me all the fucking time, right? I feel like you've had some experiences of not getting your way, things that maybe just didn't transpire into your new beginnings. I feel like when you thought something was about to kind of go forward or move forward, it just kind of ended and kind of, you know, either you fell back, someone else fell back, or the situation just didn't pan out, right? So I really feel like this month you're getting out of your head about the shoulda, coulda, wouldas, anything that didn't transpire for you, those new beginnings that just didn't happen. I feel like you're done waiting for someone, because there's a little bit of damsel in distress kind of energy here. So Gemini, I feel like you're kind of over waiting to be saved. You're like, nah, fuck that. I'm going to save myself. Like, fuck that. I'm not going to wait for someone to come and save me. I do feel like you've had some either people lurking or you've been the lurker. There's a little bit of a lurking energy here. And I want to tell you, Gemini, if you're the lurker, cut it out. That's some stalker shit. And I'm telling every sign that this card comes out, because one, I don't believe in being the stalker. I feel like if someone wanted you in their life, you would be in their life. So at some time, some point, you need to let somebody go. And I'm very, very adamant about that. And I know that tarot, unfortunately, keeps the energy of being a stalker, because you keep rewatching, you keep cross-watching their energies. And at some point, I feel like we need to let go. So I do feel a little kind of stalker energy, but I do feel like someone is falling back. Someone is not watching anymore. Some, like I said, there's something has changed this month. If someone used to be watching and waiting, someone is no longer watching you. They're no longer watching your sign, or they're no longer, you know, checking up on you. There's just something, just somebody's letting go here, okay? I feel like there's been a lot of kind of, you know, third party situations, dating around. I feel like someone lost someone because of their inability to be faithful. And I feel like this is a great loss. So in the month of November, you're still going to be feeling this, Gemini. And I just feel like no matter what, some of you are thinking about the good times you had in this person. Sometimes some of you guys, it's actually a loss, it's a death. And my heart and condolences go out to each and every one of you who lost somebody. But in the month of November, and I'm not predicting death, I think this would be something that already happened, but you are going through the emotions still and still grieving, and especially amongst friends and family members. I feel like that is something that's just truly hitting home in the month of November, especially with the holidays coming up. So I feel like it's just Gemini, it's just that kind of thing to hit, and missing family and missing those friendships. I feel like right now, Gemini, there's a part of you that just does not feel like you belong. You don't feel like you belong amongst the people around you. You feel like an outsider. You could be the black sheep of the family. You could just feel like, where are my people? Where is my soul tribe? Like, where do I fucking fit in? And I just feel like such an alien this month. And I feel like a lot of my Geminis are going through that because, one, you are the weird energy. You are the one that's different. You are the one that chooses to do things different than other people. You're a mutable sign, so you kind of go with the flow. You kind of can switch. One day you could be this, one day you could be that. And that's why people, you know, think that you're bipolar, or they think that you're fake because you today you could believe this and tomorrow you could believe something else. And it's not because you're fake, it's just because you choose to allow yourself to change and grow and not to stay stagnant in your energy, right? So I just feel like in the month it's a lot of letting go, cutting ties, and moving forward. And I really feel like one of the biggest things about this is that you're being noticed, Gemini, like you're really being noticed. So for the month of November, I feel like you got a lot of good things coming, but I also feel like there's a lot of loss and just going through the emotions and kind of feeling weird. So I feel like this month it's about finding yourself and being okay with being weird. Be okay with being not out of place. Some of you guys will realize that that was meant to be, like that was created on purpose for you and your energy to be weird, to stand out, to be the leader of change and growth amongst the other peers around you, to show them not to stay stagnant in the same shit different day. So this is kind of the energy that's coming up. And if you didn't understand why, that's why, okay? So that's what I got for you for the month of November. I hope this helps. I'm sending you some love and some light and some light and some love. Until next time, bye.